Finding the rule of a linear function. So you have two instances. You have the direct variation and the partial variation. So we're going to be looking at the direct variation. Direct variation linear function y equals ax. 1, calculate the rate of change, a, using two points that verify the rule of this function as a is equal to delta y over delta x, which is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay, so they're going to give you some values. You're going to figure out the rate of change. 2, we get a rule, y equals ax. Okay, it's y equals ax plus b, but in this case, the b is 0. Okay, whenever you have a direct variation, the b is 0. So you're getting a line, a nice oblique line that passes through the origin. Okay, for example, Andy earns an hourly wage at a pharmacy where he works. Determine the rule of the function which associates the number x of hours worked with Andy's salary y. Okay, so what we're going to do is figure out the delta y over the delta x. The delta y is going to be 240 minus 120. The delta x is going to be 20 minus 10. And that's going to give you $12 per hour. Okay, and the rule is going to be y is equal to 12x. All right, and that is pretty much it. Okay, 4, direct variation. But also we have partial variation linear functions, which is y equals ax plus b. Tell your friends. Okay, so we have, you have an x value and a y, you have an x1, a y1, and an x2 and a y2. Yeah, that's wrong. This should be x1, x2, y1, y2. This is kind of backwards. Okay, 1, calculate the rate of change, a, using two points that verify the rules for this function. So right away, you're going to figure out the rate of change, delta y over delta x, and then you're going to determine the initial value, b, after replacing x and y in the rule, y equals ax plus b. Okay, by one of the points x, y, verifying the rules of this function. That sounds like a mouthful. So what you're going to do is you know it's y equals ax plus b, right? And you've already figured out the a. So you're going to solve for the b. To solve for the b, you're going to take one of the x and y points and plug it back in. Okay, and then, if you're lucky, you get a rule, y equals ax plus b. Okay, for example, Julie earns an hourly wage and a base salary at her job. Determine the rule which associates the number x of hours worked with the total salary y, that's supposed to be a y, earned by Julie. Okay, so we have, okay, the point 1 is 10, 130. Point 2 is 20, 210. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to find the rate of change first, right? Delta y over delta x. So delta y over delta x is going to be 210, take away 130. The delta x is going to be 20, take away 10. Okay, which gives us 80 over 10, which is $8 per hour. Okay, so Julie's making $8 an hour. That's the A. Okay, so we know that y is equal to 8x plus b. Now, to figure out the b, we're just going to pick one of these points. I'm going to pick the smaller, the nicer point, the 10, 130. I'm going to plug it into that equation. Okay, so we're going to find the b value by saying y equals 8x plus b and replace the x and y with the 10 and the 130. So knowing that the point 10, 130 verifies the rule of this function, replace x and y in the rule by the coordinates of this point. So the y is replaced by 130 and the x is replaced by 10. So you have 130 is equal to 8 times 10, which is 80, plus b. So then we subtract 80 from both sides. 130 take away 80 is 50. So b is 50. Okay, so that means that Julie is earning a base salary of $50. Okay, so the rule for the whole thing is y equals 8x plus 50. And that's it for the partial variation part of our program. Have a good day.